at us, guys. Us tuning in for the first Build in Public to work on this this merch store.
So as a community, we want to experiment things together, like have unique experiences, and we also want to identify each other. Sharing this kind of experience is part of being part of a community. So we thought, well, we need a merch store. We need cool swags and cool stuff that can also identify people on different subgroups and years. So like, well, Legion will have like a collection for it, maybe in the future, Women in Near. And of course, we want to give the community the experience of paying with Near tokens and use the intents in the background. But for V1, we really want to experiment the payments. This V1 will be centralized. Yep. Will be curated. We're gonna just come up with a few items, nothing crazy, just to try out the model and the logistics and the payments and everything.
We definitely will have a Stripe integration at first. I think that's probably like an essential thing. And then we'll open it up to other payment processes, like getting a bounty out there or something for a just standard pay with Near, which is just like a contract, a little bit more complicated than a fungible transfer. You know, maybe it has an invoice. Slime, if you're listening, I know you got your invoice thing going. So all these different chances for like some integration points to help move this development along.
Based on the V1 scope, payments primarily being in Near. With the Ping widget, we support paying in Near and Fiat. Obviously, you were talking about the Stripe integration, so that would be as a separate provider. But with the Ping on-ramp, we will also, in all of the checkout widgets, be supporting paying with Fiat. That Fiat's then on-ramped and swapped via intents into the destination asset that you as the merchant would like to receive. You mentioned the NFT receipts. That's something that we're looking to integrate within the widget as well. But then Esther mentioned around the exclusive drops for Legion and things like that. One thing that we do already have integrated is discounts at checkout, specifically around holding specific tokens or NFTs. So if the person at checkout holds a Legion NFT as an example, or any of the other community NFTs like Shih Tzu, Black Dragon, all of the like core NFT communities that are near right now, the discount will be automatically applied for them and applied at the payment. Same with, we also support generic discount codes as well. So if you wanted to do like hidden codes for specific community members, that sort of thing, then we facilitate that too. The main thing behind Ping is that the Ping links, the widget, the API, all of Ping's payment infrastructure allows payment from any Near intent support asset. And then you as the merchant or like the payment receiver receives the asset that they want to receive.
Hopefully looking at a sort of demo today of and really exploring the integration of a Stripe checkout flow and hooking that up through a webhook into the Gelato API.
Looking into the flow, Elliot, the Ping would essentially sit alongside Stripe in the same way based on the conversation we had last night about the API. You would want the API to sit alongside the Stripe API for payment. Is that correct?
Yeah. Regardless of what the payment thing is, yeah, it's still a checkout. And then we need some sort of callback.
From once payment's complete with Ping, it calls back to you.
So that we can create the Gelato order. So
okay,
this is something that's happening on our end, on our server.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. Didn't work. All right, I'm gonna end it here. Such a shame. Let's get started. So Esther, I heard that something came in the mail.
Yes, so one of the partners delivered, and it's so funny, it was really fast. And they have local partners themselves. So the place they printed is the place I always print. This is why they have local solvers themselves.
Nice. This is Printful.
Yeah. So it like the way it arrives is not sexy at all. It's like really basic. But the interesting thing is that there is no label.
Okay.
But I don't know how. I think I saw the name of the local shop to do it. And it's funny because the local shop, it would cost like $10 to do it.
Yeah.
And it's costed in print for like $20. So this is the one that arrived. It's the
nice.
It's all you need paper.
Cool.
The quality of the print is not good, but it's my bad. I think I just, the design I sent, the image was not high quality. Same thing for the back. It's not really good.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So that's pretty cool. Thank you for sharing. I've also gotten some work done this week on a marketplace demo. You can sign in with your social accounts or with your Near account. So I have Google, GitHub, but we could support other ones as well. I'm going to connect with my Near wallet. A Near wallet currently needs 2 signatures to sign in, although the Intier wallet does support 1. Mm-hmm. So that'll be an update to have later. Okay, so logged in with my Near account. I can link other accounts, although it looks like that one's not going to work, but I can link maybe my Google, and it works both ways. So I could have logged in with Google first and linked the Near account later, but that's pretty cool. We got social accounts that are attached. And then we've got the shop demo, which is kind of the main focus of today. So we'll have to get your t-shirt preview in here, but this is just like a simple demo. Cool. It does a Stripe checkout.
Okay, so you do all the...
Yeah, I'm just going to put in some...
And this one, we were connected to Gelato API?
Yeah, so after this, I'll show you. So I'm going to do my checkout here. So successful payment. I've got my order. It's paid. Now, after this gets paid, we just did a Stripe reconnect here, which triggered the Gelato one. So after we did our request and we confirmed our order from Stripe, it does create the Gelato order in the Gelato dashboard. So we're not going to see it because I didn't create the company account, but that proves enough that it will kick off there. We have payment. We have on complete payment. We kick off distributor flow to whatever it is, Gelato and Printful. So I think that, yeah, like a Printful API integration would be good. So we've completed Stripe, and now we should do a crypto payment.
Mm-hmm.
Settle on product lines and like create inventory. Like what's the, in order to sell products, you know, like we have to configure them on Stripe side, and we also have to configure them on Gelato side or on Printful side. Our core inventory, which has all the data that we need. And this it like does the, you know, create product on here, create product on Gelato, create product on Stripe.
You mean like there's a bunch of data you need and you just want to organize the asks?
Yeah, for like what is a product, you know? So, which it's going to have size, but we also will probably need to do like, what is like the Gelato ID? So if you're like creating it on Gelato, what's the ID there?
Thank you for showing the demo and things that we have so far. Have a great Friday.
You too.
Have a great weekend.
Yeah, have a good weekend. Thanks for whoever tuned in. Catch you guys next time.
Bye-bye.
Bye.